By now we've seen how matrix vector multiplication can be layered on top of a dot product or an AXP operation. And what we're going to see now is how matrix-matrix multiplication can be layered on top of matrix vector multiplication. So let's have a look at how that works. Remember how when you do a matrix-matrix multiply, you compute an entry in C by taking the dot product of the corresponding row of A with the column of B that is in the same column as the corresponding column in C where this element exists. Right? Now let's think through what it would take to compute the first entry in that column. That would be the dot product of the first row with the column in B. And then the next one would be the next row with the column in B, and so forth. I should have stacked those a bit straighter. Anyway, what you notice is that computing all of these entries in the current column requires all of these dot products of the various rows with the column. And that, hopefully, you recognize as a matrix vector multiplication, the result of which updates the column of C. And obviously, you can do that for every column in C. So the way we slice and dice, how would we explain this? We would say, well, we want to compute C becomes A times B plus C. Here we focused on an individual column, but that was part of looking at all of the columns. So we would take C and then partition it into its columns. There are n of those. We would do the same thing for B. And that has to be added to the columns of C again. And what you then recognize is that A times matrix B, but viewed by columns, is the same as A times the first column, which must be added to the first column of C, A times the second column, which must be added to the second column of C, and so forth. In other words, we can think of this as looping over the columns of C using index j, and for each column of C, we update that column by doing a matrix vector multiply with the corresponding column of B, adding the result to C.